I'm a big fan of that change in general. I just shot a great 5-6 minute lesson on chords for VBL. It feels so good to wake up, pick up the bass, and immediately come up with something new and something fresh and something I was really felt motivated to share that with the members. Of course, certain things I do for VBL are themed, so you know I will create content specifically for a topic, but when something comes up just like that, really fresh, unplanned, I love that. I love being able to make the video, make it quick, edit it, upload it, and get it to the members as soon as possible. So my practice routine for the morning is pretty much done. I have an interview coming up, I think at 12, and then I wanna try and go to cryotherapy. Okay, so I rolled the foot yesterday. It is feeling better today. It isn't swollen like a soccer ball, and I can actually fit it in my shoe and I'm walking. I wasn't really walking that well last night. In fact, I wasn't really walking at all, kind of hobbled to bed. But now I'm walking, I'm up and about, and I'm gonna go to cryotherapy and go freeze my body down to minus 200 and something degrees. That will really help the rehab and inflammation and all of that stuff. The car is my listening sanctuary. So I'm listening to Keith Jarrett, Expectations. Great record. Haven't listened to it in forever. And I got a 20-minute ride to the cryotherapy. Perfect timing. Thirty-minute parking only, not a problem, because this only takes 3 minutes once you're in the chamber.
Single session?
Sure. Have you been in before?
I have, yeah. Many times, yeah. I'm from London.
London.
But I've lived in the States for 18 years. Hold the camera?
You want to record it?
Yeah, yeah. It's running right now.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
Awesome. And then people can see how utterly insane this whole process is. I don't need to see. Let's go.
Alright, 3 minutes.
3 minutes. Oh, the last 30 seconds is the longest 30 seconds of your life. And I forgot the earmuffs. Holy shit. Thank you.
You're welcome.
That was rather unpleasant, but very satisfying. Yeah, but there's no music for the first, 60 seconds?
Yeah.
There was not a lot of motivation happening there. Holy shit. All right, that was cold, but really good. That is cold.
super nice people over here at the Woodland Hills Cryo Healthcare. Amazing. I feel really, really great after that. My ankle, the rolled ankle from yesterday that was blown up like a soccer ball last night that I couldn't even work on. I feel like I could go for a run. That's how crazy good the cryotherapy is and how quickly it works. Like, my whole body feels invigorated. I feel way better. I'm like, I don't know if you can tell, I'm like a little more up now and kind of ready to go tackle a bunch of other things that I have to do today before the gig with Bob Reynolds at the Baked Potato tonight. I'm a terrible singer, but it's really important for me to sing along to records like this and to sing those melodies and internalize those melodies. That's probably one of the biggest parts of my development as an improviser, is to really spend time singing along to records. Of course, transcribing that information and playing along to those records, but singing along as well, really important. It's been a long time since I listened to this record, but I remember the piano solo being awesome, the little interlude piano solo. Here's the piano solo. Oh,
20 years, I think, since I first heard that. I used to be able to play most of that solo. Oh, it feels so good to be in the middle of that again. To remember what it meant to me to hear that for the first time. Whew, man. Wow. Yeah, that's a lot of emotions in that solo. Shit. Man. Man, Mike was one of the main reasons I moved to America. Fuck, I miss that guy, man. Shit. That was one titan of music. And a massive inspiration for so much of the stuff I've done. Crazy how those things hit you when you're not expecting it. Just 20 years of listening to someone's music like that, and to studying it and playing it and being a small part of that scene in the end of the day, and working with Randy so much, with Mike's brother. And of course, playing with Stern, with Mike Stern, who plays on that song. That's a pretty amazing feeling, I gotta say. And kind of an emotional one too. Huh? Feeling that strongly about that music really helps me keep perspective on not taking anything for granted, I think. I think that's today's lesson, actually. Little did I know when I woke up this morning that was the lesson I was going to be learning again, but I think Mike was super honest with his music, you know, and he put it all out there and let it all hang out. Never made excuses for anything and just never apologized. His music was pretty intense, and maybe it wasn't everybody's cup of tea, you know, but he never apologized for that, and he went for it. Really brave human being. And knowing how close to the end he was when he made his final record, that's seriously brave, I think. And I mean, I've always had a huge amount of respect for that music and for him and for all those people involved in that scene. And when I listen to this kind of music again and revisit it, it just reminds me of what an important part of my life that has been, and how much I owe to that music and to those musicians, and how incredibly fortunate I am to have got to work with a lot of them and make music and find happiness. You know, doesn't look very happy right now. I'm crying my eyes out listening to a Michael Brecker song, but there's a lot of deep-seated happiness in that music over the past 20 years that I am incredibly grateful for.
Cruising back from cryotherapy, and the billboard is set. For the baked potato, we will be here in about 8 hours. All right, on the way to soundcheck, stopping by Bobby's house first to pick up his mic and his pedals, because he is not making soundcheck today. He is home alone, daddy daycare, got both the kids. So I'm gonna go grab his gear for him and set it up. And I think we're gonna make a quick set list. It's good to be able to go help my buddy out.
Oh, just in from the gig. It's 1 o'clock in the morning. I'm filming on the iPhone because I can't even get up to go and get the big camera and recharge a battery because they're all flat from filming all day today. So I'm finishing the vlog on the iPhone. A bit of an emotional day today. Had its moments, but a really good day. Great gig. We really found some new things with this music. It'd be great fun to record this at some point. We're gonna do a record. This will be good with this band. But right now it is 1 a.m. The day is done. I'm up at 7, I think, tomorrow, today. The vlog is over for today. Let's put it that way. Thank you.